I imagine most of you know Marques Brownlee, YouTube's top guy for the latest on tech.
Right now I have approximately 70-ish subscribers. I have 74 subscribers. I'm going to make a Twitter, okay? Everyone has a Twitter right now, so I've got to make a Twitter. Right now I have approximately
70-ish subscribers. I'm just looking at, I have 74 subscribers. I'm going to make a Twitter, okay? Everyone has a Twitter right now, so I've got to make a Twitter.
That first voice? I converted teen Marques into an adult in seconds. Nothing fancy, but it's amazing what you can do, what anyone can do, with a free app and a bit of phonetics. But before I get into that, here's a quick quiz. Which of these two voices is lower pitched?
I've always wanted to ride a horse.
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 The correct answer is B. Okay, try these two. Which is higher pitched?
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
The correct answer is A. Now, if those answers weren't what you expected, let me explain. A voice can be broken down into two main parts. The source of the sound is the vibrating vocal folds in the larynx, which create a kind of colourless buzz. Then the cavities of the vocal tract filter or shape that buzz into recognisable speech. This is called the source filter model, developed by Gunnar Fant. I was lucky enough to know him slightly and once gave a talk at his lab in Stockholm. Now the source, the vibrating vocal folds, set the musical pitch of the voice and the intonation. And the flexible filter set the resonances, the formants, which gives us different vowels and most of our individual voice quality. Of course, both source and filter grow as we do, but not necessarily at the same rate. The best known demonstration of that is boys' voices breaking in adolescence. On average, males are bigger than females, but testosterone causes this extra lengthening of the vocal folds, often quite suddenly, which is like the strings on a guitar suddenly getting longer, and that means a lower pitch range.
And yes, my voice did break when I was only 10 years of age. I remember the day that it happened.
You're probably going to have some more time to write our own music and do music that we can do really well and that we love to play really well.
We can quite dramatically demonstrate this independence of the source and the filter the other way round, if we compare speakers who have a relatively average larynx, but exceptionally sized vocal tracts. The actor Richard Kiel was over 7 feet tall and had a much larger than average filter.
I'm one of your biggest fans.
Well, that's very nice of you.
I'm one of your biggest fans.
His vocal folds, however, weren't so exceptional. We can show this by shrinking his vocal tract digitally, which is amazingly easy using the app Praat or Praat. It's the industry standard app for analysing speech in phonetics, but it's completely free. To effectively shrink Richard Kiel, we can use this feature, which they call Change Gender. But what it's actually doing is letting you modify independently the pitch range and the formants, the resonances of the filter. So let's take this short clip.
I've always wanted to ride a horse. I've always wanted to ride a horse.
And leaving his pitch untouched, we'll raise the resonances of his vocal tract.
I've always wanted to ride a horse. I've always wanted to ride a horse.
Now to my ears, that's a pretty average sounding male voice. You might think the shifted voice sounds higher pitched than his original voice.
I've always wanted to ride a horse.
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 But the pitch contour in blue is the same for both.
I've always wanted to ride a horse.
I've always wanted to ride a horse.
Just listen to the first vowel in the word always. It's the same musical pitch in both versions. What's different is these undulating dark bands, the formants, which are all shifted up on the right, as if produced with a much smaller filter vocal tract. We can do the exact same in reverse with Kenny Baker, the actor inside the original R2-D2.
Drop me in, feet into the feet of the robot. I'm sitting in a safety seat, a child's safety seat with a harness. And I'm in there, that's it.
Here's the original on the left.
Feet into the feet of the robot. Feet into the feet of the robot.
And in the version on the right, I've shifted all his formants downwards.
Feet into the feet of the robot. Feet into the feet of the robot. Feet into the feet of the robot.
To me, his voice now sounds a lot more average. But as before, the pitch contours are the same. Listen to just the word feet.
Feet. Feet. Feet.
Feet. Feet. Feet.
It has the same musical pitch in both versions. And in the quiz before, I tweaked the pitches a little bit in the opposite directions. So the seemingly higher voice actually had a slightly lower pitch.
I've always wanted to ride a horse.
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 And the seemingly lower voice had a slightly higher pitch.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
I just go off and do my own thing, and it happens anyway.
Of course, it has to be said, not all people with dwarfism have noticeably different voices.
But I was born on the New Jersey shore, and actually his manager, his first manager when he was a teenager, lived next door to us.
And now let's look at Marques Brownlee. He started his YouTube tech reviews on January 1st, 2009, just after turning 15.
All right, welcome to my first video.
And luckily for us, he's kept what I think are all his old videos online, making it a fantastic longitudinal data set. Of course, it would have been nice if he'd started when he was 9 or 10, because the biggest male pitch drop is on average between age 10 and 14. But his voice still dropped dramatically between 2009 and 2010. Just listen to these clips and watch how his voice's favoured pitch region, shown in red on these distribution plots, steadily decreases.
I'm going to make a Twitter, okay? Everyone has a Twitter right now, so I've got to make a Twitter.
So stay tuned, I'm not dead, I'm still on YouTube, and I think I just reached 900 subscribers, and I'm getting like 300 to 400, 500 views per video, depending on how popular it is.
1920 by 960, that is the dimension to the new YouTube mega widescreen player. And I actually kind of like it.
That connects via Firewire or USB. You can stream in high frame rates using this camcorder, and it'll look very, very good.
So that's just a quick video I had to put up just to let you guys know how I rate my products. So whenever you see an 8.5 out of 10 for me, I'll let you know what that's relative to. And
I think the question really is, does the software you use work on ARM? Like, that's the main question you should be considering when thinking about if you're going to buy one of these things.
But meanwhile, his formants shifted much less. Listen to Marques saying I, age 15, and age 30.
I.
You can see the similar formant pattern that we'd expect in this diphthong. The lowest formant, F1, moves down, and the one above, F2, moves up. It's a bit clearer if we turn on the formant tracks. The slightly lower up on the right. It's something like a 10 to 20% difference. But if we turn off the formants and show pitch instead,
I.
Marques used a similar rising intonation pattern in both recordings, but as we saw in those distribution plots, the difference in pitch is way bigger. In other words, Marques Brownlee's voice now feels lower, mainly from changes in the source. So let's try to reproduce some of these effects with Praat. If we take adult Marques, leave his pitch untouched, but shift his formant range up and down, we can get sounds that I think are reminiscent of large Richard Kiel and small Kenny Baker.
It's not like the super high-end gaming performance. I'm not talking about that type of performance, but I just mean like a general smoothness and consistency and rock-solid performance across all your everyday regular tasks, that sort of performance.
It's not like the super high-end gaming performance. I'm not talking about that type of performance, but I just mean like a general smoothness and consistency and rock-solid performance across all your everyday regular tasks, that sort of performance.
To get something more like a rejuvenating effect, we need to make a far smaller adjustment to performance and a way bigger adjustment to the pitch range.
The M3 13-inch MacBook Air
absolutely got a big bump up. 120 hertz LCD touchscreen. There's pretty good support for native apps as far as things people use every day.
Of course, it's not perfect for various reasons, like differences in the voice quality due to differences in how the vocal folds vibrate and subtle differences in how the formants change relative to each other, as well as his developing style of delivery. A bit more impressive, I think, is taking this 2010 recording and aging it by finding what seemed to be the sweet spot adjustments to his pitch and formant ranges.
Who's going to make a keynote in iLife on a tablet? You see what I'm getting at? Say no to the iPad. If you're interested in a giant iPod Touch that's overpriced and overhyped, then go for it. I mean, if you like things with Apple logos on them, there's your thing. Otherwise, like I said, stick with what you got. MKBHD here, signing out.
Peace. Now, before you go,